But let's have a look. I'm going to look at this as the integral, and then we have sine. I'm going to take out one of the sine x factor. So sine to the n minus 1 power times sine x dx. Now, why did I do that? Check this out. Once we have this, we can do the integration by parts, the DM method on the side, as follows. I will be differentiating this instead. So we're looking at sine to the n minus 1 power of x. And then I'm going to integrate sine x. That's how we can produce the cosine. When we integrate sine x, we get negative cosine. When we differentiate this, put the n minus 1 to the front, and make sure we put parentheses, and then subtract 1 to the power, so sine n minus 2, and then the chain rule, we multiply by cosine x. Now, if we do this times that, we get just that, right? So I'm just going to put it together. It's negative, and then we have sine n minus 1, and then we have cosine, so that's good. That's good. And then we see that we are going to multiply these two things together, and we will just have minus, and then we have, let's put on actually, minus minus is plus. And then we have the n minus 1, and then we have the integral. And now we have sine n minus 2 and cosine, which is cosine squared x. Huh, it works out so nice. It works out so nicely. Why? Because we can see that cosine squared x is actually just 1 minus sine squared x. And we can distribute this again. And now, take a look though. The moment we distribute this, we will end up with the integral of sine to the nth power again. That's a duplication from the original one. So this is what I'm going to do. Based on what we have done so far, I will tell you the left-hand side, we have the integral of sine to the nth power x dx. This right here gives us the first part of the answer, which is negative sine to the n minus 1 x cosine x. And then I'm going to just put this times that, right? So we will add n minus 1 times the integral of sine to the n minus 2 x dx. I closed this already. And this is good because it is a power reduction, you see? And we don't have anything else in this integral. But don't forget, we still have the other part. We'll take this, right? Earlier we did this times that, and now we have to take this times that. Sine to the n minus 2 power times sine squared is just sine to the nth power. And as I said, that's a repeat from the earlier. That's why I write this down again. We still have this factor, but this is a negative. So it's a minus, and then we have n minus 1. And then we have the integral sine to the nth power x dx. Now, why did I write this down again? Because we will have to add this to the other side, combine it. So we add n minus 1 times the integral sine to the nth power x dx. This and that will cancel. And of course, let's come here. We add n minus 1 integral sine to the nth power x dx. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is one integral plus n minus 1 times this. Ignore this for now. 1 plus n minus 1, 1 cancels, so we have n times the integral sine to the n x dx. Right, this is how we usually deal with a repeated integral when we see a... This is how we usually deal with an integration by part when we see a repeating situation. A famous example is the integral of sine to the third power, secant to the third power x. But anyway, I'll just write this down again. So this right here is negative sine to the n minus 1 x and n cosine x and then plus n minus 1 integral sine n minus 2 x dx. Not done yet. I will have to divide everybody by n. So integral, that doesn't look like an integral, that looks like a stretched 5. Integral sine to the nth power x dx equals negative 1 over n times sine to the n minus 1 power of x times cosine of x. And then we add, again, divided by n, so n minus 1 over n times the integral sine to the n minus 2 power x dx. This is the reduction formula that we like to use for sine to the nth power.